Welcome to know about the history of transportation in Guayaquil before and now. The streets of Guayaquil City have been passing from the horse-drawn carriage to electric trams and buses. Although the streets of our city no longer keep the spaces used in the old carriage visible, it was possible to serve them until the last century, which allowed citizens to get closer to the remembered image of colonial Guayaquil. But carriages were part of the human landscape.
During the 19th and early 20th centuries, these carriages were the first taxis used by our people. This type of urban transport, also known by the name of point cars, is clearly a pleasant historical memory of many Guayaquil residents. In 1873, the operation of the first urban transport in the port city was recorded. The Salado Company offered the service in animal-drawn fleets, two mules that slid on rails, which were also called blood cars.
According to the book Urban Transportation in Guayaquil between the years 1893 to 1885, the anonymous social urban cars enterprise was created, which renewed the fleet in the city and until later bought the one from El Salado. The San Francisco Square was a point where the pretero drivers stopped to pick out passengers. It's assured that the most curious and remembered of the company car was the one that the Guayaquil people had signed with the name of Crazy Cove, which crossed the October 9th Street all along to reach the Baños del Salado, where later the American Park would be built, which was of the main roads of this transportation system.
These flows that move on rail have different names according to their characteristics. For example, the impaired vehicle that was double-decker, or the gondola, a platform with 8 transfer seats. The routes were circular, since they start from a street turn and return by a parallel road. For example, a road from Malecon to Plaza Colón and return through Rocafuerte. In 1887, it spread through Chile and Chimborazo towards the Hippodrome in the south.
On January 15, 1910, the first electric tram service was inaugurated. These cars provide greater comfort and speed to the user. The traditional routes that were maintained for 4 decades at the service of the citizens were from Industrial Street, current Eloyal Faro, and Chile to the workshop of the Light Enterprise in the Sur, Rocafuerte, Plaza Colón, Malecón, and the current Sucre, Colón, Army, and Vélez. The new tram system led to the bankruptcy of the Urban Car Company, which was directed by the businessman Rodolfo Vaquerizo Moreno. Only until 1930 did horse or mule drawn tram last, and the last electric tram ran until 1950.
Although history has not been able to find precise dates of when the first buses appeared in the city, it is certain among the first pioneer lines in the city, there are lines 2 and 3 of the Guayaquil Cooperative and line 4 of the Gran Colombia Cooperative around the years 1955 and 1960. In 1974, a new route was created, Line 16, which did not change its route and did not route it like the other 16 lines that already existed.
The advance in urban transportation continues and since 2006, the city of Guayaquil inaugurated an exclusive route for the passage of buses of the Metrovía system.
The evolution of public transport is due to the need for more and more rapid transport. The idea is to be able to reach your destination sooner and at a cost that is not high, so that it does not affect the economy of citizens and benefits everyone, the users.
But time does not stand still, and with it, the new means of urban transportation do not wait. Guayaquil has already undertaken a new challenge and now has the Airborne Transport or Aerovía, a project promoted by the Guayaquil Cabildo, which links this city with Durán, and when users move inside cabins supported by cables. And this is how we have taken a tour through the history of urban transportation in Guayaquil, from its beginnings until now.